From all the tools that nature has provided us, light is one of the most extraordinary ones. The utility of light to illuminate our world is intrinsically connected to our ability to control light itself. Remarkably, in addition to many well-known properties such as intensity, wavelength, or pulse duration, light can be twisted, and thus it can possess angular momentum.
Since the beginning of last century, it is well known that photons possess a spin, which is associated with the polarization of light. But it was not until 1992 that it was realized that light can possess an extra twist, which is the orbital angular momentum, linked with the rotation of the wavefront of the light. Beams carrying orbital and angular momentum are also known as vortex beams, and their intensity has a donut-like shape.
In an international collaboration between the University of Salamanca, GILA, University of Colorado at Boulder, and ICFO, the Institute of Photonic Sciences, we have discovered that light can possess a new property, the self-torque of light.
Torque in mechanical systems is associated to the temporal variation of angular momentum. In our group at the University of Salamanca, we came with the idea that light can exhibit an orbital angular momentum that varies in time. Thus, light beams can possess a self-torque. We found out that extreme ultraviolet beams with self-torque can be naturally generated through the nonlinear process of high harmonic generation. This new type of light beams possess an orbital angular momentum that varies continuously at the sub-femtosecond time scale.
At the University of Salamanca, we are experts in performing theoretical simulations of high harmonic generation, including both microscopic and macroscopic physics. Our simulations confirmed that extreme ultraviolet beams with self-torque can be generated, and thus we contacted our colleagues at the University of Colorado.
Yeah, so I remember when the Salamanca team first told us about the self-torque of light in this experiment, we really scratched our heads a lot about this. Optical orbital angular momentum is not such a trivial subject to begin with, and so when you add a time dependence into the profile of these beams, things get very interesting. Here at GILA, we've really been exploring the limits to high harmonic generation. How can we control these light sources? Can we control their polarization, their energy, their brightness, and do this all in a very short wavelength regime of the optical spectrum? And really that beautiful coherent physics of high harmonic generation is what makes this experiment possible and the ability for us to generate self-torqued light beams. Normally when we drive HHG with OAM beams or donut laser beams, those emit high harmonic donuts. But with self-torque, we take two visible donut beams, separate them by just a little bit in time, and then make the harmonics with that. When we do that, the beam that is emitted actually looks like a croissant, and this croissant contains over an octave of orbital angular momentum values along the light pulse. And that's the unique property of the self-torque of light.
Yeah, the challenge that we have is to measure this optical version of whirlwind, where instead of air molecules twisting around, we have light that twists faster and faster. So we begin to ask ourselves a simple question: can we harness this beautiful quantum physics of high harmonic generations so that we can see the signature of this new property in our light beams?
At this point, we were thinking, how on earth can we measure an orbital angular momentum variation at the sub-femtosecond timescale? Fortunately, we sorted out that beams with self-torque, they carry an azimuthal frequency chirp.
Azimuthal frequency chirp means that the frequency changes spatially along the donut-like shape. The relevance of this finding was huge, as then our colleagues at GILA were able to measure and characterize the self-torque of light.
And that connection by the Salamanca team to see the time-varying orbital angular momentum is related to an azimuthal frequency chirp was really key to confirming the self-torque of light. Because without this, there'd be no way to measure it. A sub-femtosecond variation in orbital angular momentum just can't be extracted by any of our known techniques for characterizing laser pulses.
So we realized by collapsing the beam spatially, we could map the azimuthal frequency chirp in the beam onto a spatial chirp. And then by dispersing the harmonics and measuring the spatial chirp and azimuthal extent of each of the individual harmonic orders, we could extract the self-torque. And fortunately, this measurement can be made with just the combination of a cylindrical mirror and an extreme ultraviolet grating.
This is the first time that anyone has predicted or even observed this new property of light, so the immediate applications are not obvious. For example, we can think that we can modulate the orbital angular momentum of light in the same way as frequencies modulated in communications. From the fundamental science point of view, this new structural property adds a new degree of freedom to study the dynamics of the light-matter interaction.
And this new degree of freedom in these light pulses really opens exciting opportunities. For instance, we've been thinking, can these short wavelength whirlwinds be applied to study chiral molecules at the nanoscale, enabling new kinds of dichroic spectroscopies? For example, many of the materials that make up the advanced technological devices in our hands, such as our smartphones or our solid-state magnetic hard drives, are driven by ultra-fast nanoscale physics that we don't have a complete picture of. Self-torque light pulses offer a new avenue to study these dynamics and may lead to discoveries that will advance the next generation of technological materials.